Hi and welcome to May 2018 Patreon video. Just a quick heads up, there's not going to be as much artwork this month as there has been, especially last month where I had all the time in the world. I went back to work this month, so yay! But at the same time, now I have less time to actually draw my own stuff. On top of that, last month I also finished writing the Drawfu book, and now I'm putting it together, and it's tough going. It's taking a long time, so a lot of the time I would have a lot of artwork because I'd be doing the Drawfu lessons, but I'm no longer working on them right now, so there's also less art for that. And later I'm going to be uploading some of the things that I forgot to scan this week, which is some things from my sketchbook, which I think I should have scanned last month. But then I'm gonna take some photos, which I also forgot, of the figure drawing that I did this month. I actually did figure drawing this month. I've been neglecting figure drawing for the last 2 or 3 months. And that is in part because of feedback videos for my coaching. So from moving forward, I'm going to reserve doing I'm going to have my Tuesdays off, so I'm not going to do any coaching feedback on Tuesday nights. Monday nights is fine. Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday nights, I'm going to try to get them done. But on Tuesday nights, I would like to go to figure drawing because I really need it. It's very helpful. So I'm going to do that from moving on from that this point on. So let's get on with the artwork that I'm going to be working on, that I'm going to be sending today. And it's actually only going to be 2 pieces of artwork plus the figure drawings that are going to be being uploaded later. And so here we have a rough of the drawing that I started working on this month. So this is the rough, and if you notice that there's a red line around, a red border. The red border is for the print. So this is how far the paper goes. Okay, so this is an 11 by 17 sheet of paper. So this is, so when I print it out, this is where the cutoffs will be. And beyond the border is, I'm going to make this a digital desktop wallpaper. So it just extends outside of there so that the digital desktop paper art will be a little bit wider. And so here's the rough, and then I tightened it up. So here's the digital ink pass. It's got a lot of black spots all over the place, but this is the look of what it's going to be. So now that I had the digital ink pass, what I decided to do is I was going to start to color it. And the coloring process is going to be experimental. So I'll show you where I'm at. Oh wait, well let me show you what I was thinking. Well, no, I'm going to show you what I did right now, which is I put this texture and on it, and here it is. So I put a texture on it, and then I flatted all the characters. The reason it's taking me so long is because each individual character needed to be given a color, and it takes a long time to just color every single little bit in the drawing. So far, this is what it's looking like. There's a shadow over here. It would probably be called done if I was thinking about it in any other way than I am right now. I am going to be painting it a lot more. So this is actually just the undercoat, the underdrawing. And then on top of that, I'm going to start modeling it, and it's going to look a little bit more, it's going to be a little bit more modeled, and it's going to not have the line work. And so this here is how I was thinking about it and I was approaching this. So this is my thumbnails. And so I was just trying to get the general light. So there's going to be light source coming from the right hand side. Everything here is going to be in shadow. So I kind of already did that, but since it's going to be sunlight, I'm going to lighten this up even more This is white because of the sunlight. So this, she needs a little bit more light coming in on her and all this other stuff. So so I added color just to see what it would look like here. And I tried a different light source here, like a little bit darker, but I ended up not liking the way that looked. So I think I'm gonna keep it a little bit much lighter, as if the light from like a window is coming in here and it's just bouncing all over the place, illuminating even the darker areas of the room. So this is my thumbnail. And this is, again, this is how it's turning out so far. I'm happy right now where it is. So I'm in the process of adding some kind of form shadows on everything right now. I called it ambient light, but it's actually just adding form shadows. Well, coming from an ambient light, but I just got to be a little bit more careful with the ambient light that I'm going to be putting in on it. But it's, you can't see it visibly here. Also, all of these plush toys are from different not all of them, but a lot of them are from different cartoonists from all over the internet. So, like for example, this is Boulder and Fleet from Jersey Droz's comic strip Boulder and Fleet. This is from Javier Hernandez's El Muerto. This is from John David Guerra's Nightmare Pro Wrestling. This is from Danger Squad. His name is Dirk from Duran. He was the one that gave me the idea to put these plush toys in here based off of characters. This is from my pal John. He's his Cholo Libre. And right here, this guy over here is Matt Schofield's Steamroller Man. He's one of the storyboard directors on The Simpsons. And this is a very funny comic strip that he's doing online. And then I got some of my own comic strip characters in the back here. And here's Black Parakeet. So, yeah, that's those are kind of some of the Easter eggs in here. All right. And then the next drawing that I did was, let's see if I can. So this broken piece of art is the first pass of Lara Croft that I did. She got broke. She's broken here because I was fixing something in a layer, and I think somehow this layer got caught up in it and it got broken. But so I was gonna draw this. This is for the postcard giveaway. So I was going to draw this, and this was going to be the postcard. But I mean, it was okay. It's not there's anything horribly wrong with it, but I was really not happy with the fact that it was kind of dull. I didn't like that it was just her looking, I don't know. I wanted there to be more to the drawing. So I talked to a friend of mine, said, I'm not really happy with it. And he's like, you know what? Satisfy yourself. If you're not happy with it, even if people like it and it's doing fine and it's and it's drawn in a way that you like, don't be afraid to just toss it. So I tossed it and I started again, and I did this one instead. And for this, I'm much, much happier with it. And so here's the final. So everybody's gonna get a digital copy of this. The postcard, I am still working on it. So here's the thing. In the previous postcards, the frames, these frames I've done by hand. And to put it mildly, they've come out extremely sloppy. I just haven't been happy with the way that I managed that. So I decided, because you need precision tools and it's better to have it extremely precise, I decided that even though I use precision tools, I use circle templates and French curves and things like that to make the line work. Computers are extremely good at making precision shapes. Why am I trying to emulate what a computer can do so easily? So I decided that I was no longer going to hand do these frames. I was going to just print them out black when I print out the blue line. So I'm going to show you, this is my test print of the postcard. It's a test print because, you know, there's two sides now, because I was printing it out and I was having trouble with the toner, and I was having trouble, this is a little bit off center, so you see how off center this is, and so I centered it and I just wanted to make sure that it was centered. But notice that this is blue, this is light blue. So the final, this isn't the final, I have another one that has a blank, has just this all by itself in the blank side. And if you notice here, there's a little bit of gray on this side. And that's because I tested it out to make sure that the marker, the alcohol in the marker, didn't smudge the printer ink, and it doesn't. So that was my test here. So this is my test postcard. But the final postcard, see how it's light? You could see the figure in here. I'm going to hand ink the figure, and then I'm going to hand color it with marker. And one thing that I haven't done is scan the thumbnail. So that's another thing that you will be receiving. There's going to be a picture of it right here. Or right here somewhere. Of that. So that you could at least see what that looks like so far. But I'm going to scan it in so far and what you're going to see. All right. Great. Now I'm going to tell you who's going to win this drawing once it's done. Okay, so the postcard winner for this month is Steve Howard. Steve, you won the postcard this month. It's going to be Laura Croft. It's going to be hand-drawn, hand-inked. She's going to be hand-drawn. The borders won't be, but she will be hand-drawn and it will be hand-colored. So congratulations, Steve. Will win this. I think this is, as far as I know, this is the first time you've won a postcard. So congratulations. So thank you so much for being my patron. I hope this is not discouraging that I'm not producing as much, but believe me, once it's done, it's gonna look really nice. But it takes time to really work out. There's just too many elements in the drawing. There's a lot of work that goes into these into this drawing. So each one of these guys needs to be given form shadows, and then it's gonna be painted. I'll see about experimenting with faster ways of painting so it doesn't take as long. But at the end of the day, I only get to spend about an hour and a half working on a drawing, and it really slows me down. It's not like when I was on hiatus when I could just spend hours and hours on it. So thank you so much for supporting me. I really, really appreciate it. One more thing. On the weekends, I've been working on doing paid course videos. So I'm starting to create a course. I'm working on it now. The course is going to be a video course of the lesson zero, the level zero lessons in my DrawFu website. It's going to give you the information from those lessons in a video format, as well as it's going to expound. Over the years of having it out there, there's been a lot of other questions, a lot of things that I am going to address in the video that is not necessarily just in the website. There's going to be a few more elements to it than that. There's going to be new artwork. It's going to be the same information, but it's going to be shown in a different way. It's going to be visual. And then, like I said, I'm going to add a little bit more information in there. There's going to be slightly different ideas about the exercises. I'm going to address a lot of commonly asked questions that I've gotten over the years about the lessons. So I'm very excited about it. I've been attempting to record two videos a weekend, so that it could get done as fast as possible. Right now, as of the time of this recording, I've got 4 out of 8 videos done. So I'm gonna try to get another one done this weekend, if not two, because I'm trying for two a weekend. I'll let you know when it comes out, but I am letting you know now that it's coming. So if you're one of those people who read the stuff but you're like, I don't get it, or if you are much more of a visual learner, then this is going to be perfect for you. It's not going to be super expensive, because this is kind of an entry level course. So I'm going to try to make it so that it's manageable financially. It's so, you know, if you want to commit, you can commit. If you just want to do it as a hobby, it's got like, it'll be like a bit of a hobby type of price. But thank you so much for all your support, and so does my family. Thanks you, and I will see you next time. All right, bye.